Do you want to try to keep your ancestry and family search family trees in sync? Well, to do that, the easiest way to do it is to use a program called RootsMagic. And since RootsMagic 8 is available, it's time to update you on how to sync your trees between FamilySearch and Ancestry using RootsMagic. Now, in a previous video, I have talked with RootsMagic creator Bruce Busby on how to sync your trees, and there are a couple of things that you have to know in order for this to be successful. First, if you have your tree on RootsMagic and you want to send it up to Ancestry, you have to create a new tree on Ancestry. You cannot add your RootsMagic tree to an existing or old tree on Ancestry. It doesn't work. You have to upload a new tree from RootsMagic to Ancestry. So it is most important for you to decide if Ancestry is the most important place for your tree to be, if you already have something there. If you do, then what you need to do is you need to download your tree from Ancestry into RootsMagic. Once you have your Ancestry tree in RootsMagic, then you can one at a time, it's kind of slow, but I'll show you how it happened. One at a time, you can upload information about specific individuals into FamilySearch. There is no bulk upload into FamilySearch. So you can do that. The other thing you can do, if your family tree is primarily in FamilySearch and you want to go over to Ancestry, or if you don't mind starting a new tree on Ancestry, then download your tree from FamilySearch. You can do a fairly large bulk download on FamilySearch. You can download it into RootsMagic. You can upload it into Ancestry. And then what happens is when you make a change here, you can pass it through and make it go over here. It is step by step and vice versa. So now that we have the instructions out of the way, let's go show you actually how to do it over in RootsMagic. The first thing you have to do is start a new file. So we're going to click on File, Create a new RootsMagic file, and we're going to download from an online tree. We're going to start with the Ancestry to FamilySearch way of syncing your trees. So we're going to download an Ancestry member tree. And the first thing you have to do is decide where do you want this tree to be on your computer. So I already have a file that's my RootsMagic file under Documents, but if you don't know where you want yours to be, then you click on Browse to Destination, and then you can browse where you want it to be. So for me, RootsMagic 8, okay. But what I can do right now is I already have my folder here. So I'm gonna click there, I'm in RootsMagic 8, and I'm gonna say New Mexico tree, and click Save. So now I have several choices to choose from. First, I need to decide what format do I want it in. Do I want date, month, year? Do I want month, year, comma, date? There's lots of different options for you to choose from. I am so used to this format, I can't change it any other ways. Now there are some reference numbers, maybe some personal reference and record numbers that you're going to use, or you want to see the FamilySearch ID. I find it distracting, so I leave it at none. For the last 20 years, I've always had a surname written in uppercase, but thanks to Family History Fanatics viewers, I've discovered that there are some names where it doesn't really work. So this is for you to decide. Do you want the surnames to be uppercase on the reports and also in the views of the trees that you're going to see here in a moment, or do you want lowercase? The next option is LDS support. If you're a member of The Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints and you have an LDS account on FamilySearch, then you probably want to go ahead and turn on LDS support. It's going to give you the temple information you're looking for. If you're not a member of The Church of Jesus Christ of Latter-day Saints, you probably don't need that information. The next thing I always turn on are FamilySearch, Family Tree support, which enables hints, linkings, and so on and so forth, as well as enable web hints. These web hints are going to be from Ancestry, Find My Past, My Heritage, and Family Search. Whenever there's hints, then Roots Magic is actually going to be able to show you that the hints are available on those platforms from one location. I really like that. So go ahead and click OK after you've made your selection. The next thing that's going to happen is that Roots Magic is going to invite you to sign in to your account on Ancestry. Once I've signed in, Roots Magic will tell me all of the trees that I have on Ancestry, and I can find the one I'm looking for. So this is the New Mexico tree, and I can start downloading. Now, I do have to advise you, if you have a large tree, this is going to take a long time, because not only does Roots Magic download the content of your tree, it will also download all media associated with what you've linked to your tree. Meaning, if you have linked a city directory source to your profile, it will grab the image and save it to your computer. For some of you, that's going to be a blessing. For me, it is a total annoyance. So I tend to try to only download small trees in this way and then update from there. Keep that in mind. If there's ever an update so that you cannot download the media files, I will let you know. But right now, I can't find it. So when I do download the tree, it's going to go through the process. It's going to download your tree. It's going to import information from Ancestry into Roots Magic. And now it proceeds to download the media files. Now for me, this tree didn't have a lot of media, so yay, I'm happy go lucky. And I have all of the people here from Ancestry that I had created online, and they're all in Roots Magic. And you can see I have my Roots Magic tree on the left, my Ancestry tree on the right, and everything is in alignment because I just downloaded all of that information. So now, what if you want to connect this person to FamilySearch? Whenever you see a blue icon in this box, that means that Roots Magic has linked that person to someone in your tree, to someone in FamilySearch's family tree. So when we first start out, we're going to not have an icon, so you can't see it there, but if you hover over these three little circles, it's going to pop up and it's saying not linked to family search. So I'm going to click on not linked to family search. And then what's going to happen is Roots Magic is going to search the family search database for a possible person that matches my ancestor in the tree, my relative. So the names match up. When they match up perfectly, it's green. If it's slightly off, it'll be yellow. And if it's different, it'll be red. So these names match up fairly closely. There's a little bit of variation, and then the last names match up as well. So what I'm going to go ahead and do is I'm going to click on this box next to the name, and then I'm going to get this pop up and it says match with family search. Yes. So I'm going to click match. And now I have linked this person to family search, but notice there's still some changes. So what am I going to do then? Well, now I can go and click on the side-by-side again. It's going to pull up the information I have from Ancestry in my Roots Magic program. And now I have information from Family Search, and I can make a couple of decisions. I can decide to update from Ancestry into Family Search, or bring information from Family Search over to Roots Magic. Right now, there's just an update that I want to make, that I have a birth date that I want to take over to Family Search. I can click on this little I, and it's going to tell me what sources I found that information from. Since it's January 1867, it's from that 1900 census. So I'm going to click on birth, and I can click replace in Family Search the 1868. I'm going to replace it with the information I have right here. Unfortunately, I can't find a way to overwrite just January, but keep the location. So then I have a decision to make. I can either change it here, like I'll show you, or I can do it a different way. So let me go ahead and show you the first way to update. So I'm going to say date on 1900 census. So I'm going to click OK. It'll take a little while. If you can't see it update, then go ahead and click this reload. And now you can see that the change has taken place. However, in 1867, this was actually New Mexico territory, not New Mexico, USA. So I'm going to show on Family Search. I'm going to edit my change on family search. And I updated the statement, birth date on the 1900 census, but New Mexico at this time was a territory, and I have my Grammarly going off telling me to combine that as one word. I'm going to go ahead and click save. And now what's going to happen when I reload is notice January 1867 is the same, but this one has New Mexico, USA. This one has New Mexico territory. So whenever you make a change, see that there's a change on family search and you want to move it to Ancestry, then you click on the change you want to make. And then you'll choose the option replace in RootsMagic 1867, New Mexico, and it's going to overwrite that information and it makes that change automatically. So we're going to close that out because now we need the information to go to Ancestry. Come down to this box at the bottom and click on the Ancestry tab. And then this view will show up. And we have to go and find the person we changed. So this was Abuelina there, this one. And you can see that it has the icons for RootsMagic and for Ancestry. One thing that you might want to take advantage of is there's only show changed people. And that makes it easier to know who's been changed either on FamilySearch, RootsMagic, or Ancestry. Move this over just a little bit more. And now what I'm going to do is notice how these two facts are different. So I can go ahead and click on this arrow, add an existing event on Ancestry, update an existing, or delete. I'm going to do update. And what I really like about this update form is I can do one item. So if it had said about 1867 in January 1867, I could just choose that fact. I can choose multiple facts. I'm going to go ahead and just update to here, to Utah territory. And then when I like all the changes, what I like about the Ancestry one is that I can accept changes and then RootsMagic will apply them all at one time. So that's if you have your tree on Ancestry. And that's if you want to update things on FamilySearch. Yes, the FamilySearch changes are going to be one fact at a time, one person at a time. That's just the way it is. But in Ancestry, you can make multiple changes in one fell swoop. If you made it this far into this video, that means that you're enjoying our content. Now, there's many ways that you can continue to help us bring you the latest, greatest content. And that includes checking out our blog, becoming a channel member, hitting the subscribe button, hitting the like button, leaving a comment, sharing this video with your friends, and more. All of these little contributions helped us continue to make great content to help you enjoy your genealogy journey. To download your tree from FamilySearch, we click on FamilySearch and we choose our folder. And this time I'm going to do the Luan tree. I'm going to make the selections. What I'm going to do is I can either start with myself using my FamilySearch account, or I can select somebody using their personal identification number from FamilySearch. Now you can do multiple generations, but I'm going to highly recommend that you don't, because all of your lines will come down and you want to make sure that your tree isn't full of junk. So I wouldn't do very many branches. For this video, I'm just going to go ahead and do two generation of ancestors, or I'll go ahead and do two generation of descendants. So I'm going to use Joseph Lanborn. I'm going to import. And notice this can take a while. When you're doing the import, make sure that you're doing it overnight or any time that there's a real, you don't have to do anything to make it work. Now that I have the tree, I can sync this with Ancestry. So what I need to do is come down to the Ancestry icon right here, click on that. And now because Ancestry either allows you to download a tree, create a new file, or upload a tree from a current RootsMagic file, then I'm going to go ahead and click upload. I'm not going to upload my media. I'm only going to upload my sources, my notes, my places, no private facts, no private notes. I'm not going to allow others to view this tree, and I'm going to create tree and upload the file. Now, if you wanted to upload it, the media, you could do that. I tend to not do that. Once you have uploaded your information to the Ancestry tree, you'll be able to upload, make changes. from Ancestry to FamilySearch in the way we showed in the previous video. Now, there are a lot of things we can do with updating information between the different websites, but now you are off to a great start to be able to change information between the trees back and forth. If you have any further questions, be sure to drop them in the comment section and be sure to stay tuned for future videos on how to do things with RootsMagic to improve your genealogy research journey. If you want more genealogy research tips and tricks, be sure to check the playlist at the top. And if you're ready for our latest video, check out the one right there. If you want to learn how to do more genealogy research tasks and